제242회 가져갈 필요가 없겠군요.
Hello everyone and welcome to Let's Speak Korean, my favorite show on Arirang TV. And I'm sure yours too, right, Stephen?
Absolutely. But I don't think it's too fair. I think we're a little biased.
Well,
we're
not allowed to. Show.
Okay, yes, it is our favorite show. 안녕하세요. I'm Stephen Revere and I'll be coaching you guys through the Korean language today. And we have a couple of students. Yeah. Is it your favorite show? You're a little biased too, though.
That's true. Hi, Stephen. Hi, Lisa. 여러분, 안녕하세요. As you remember, my name is Marina. I'm from Ukraine. And just, I want to say hi to all my parents, just to my mom, to my daddy. I miss you so much.
네, 여러분 안녕하십니까? My name is Martinez, but everybody calls me Maru. So I also want to send greetings to my mother, my father, my brother, then to my grandmother, all my friends, and okay, to all Lithuania.
All Lithuania, and my dog. All right, we're going to be talking more about our house, our newly 구한 house, the house that we found. And so let's take a look at our dialogue for today.
Wrap it up
with Lisa
and Steven.
Outfit을 그냥 버린다고요?
새 집에 붙박이장이 있거든요.
그래서 가져갈 필요가 없겠군요.
옷장이 없어서 집이 엄청 넓어 보여요. 히.
Of course, when we move, we usually throw out the old stuff and buy some new stuff. So it seems like Steven's going to get rid of his closet, okay? 옷장을 그냥 버린다고요? You're going to just throw away your closet and note that why would you throw away your closet?
Yeah, and it's actually almost impossible to throw away a closet. We think of 옷장 as closet, but 옷장 is more like a wardrobe, right? In Korea, usually the closet is not in the building already, so you have to buy one and carry it with you from place to place. However, in more modern apartments, this has started to change, and they have added something you'll see in the next sentence
the
that is much more like a closet. Yes, 옷장 is a wardrobe.
So Stephen responds by saying, in my new house, we have a 붙박이장. Oh, new word. 새 집에 붙박이장이 있거든요. What is a 붙박이장? Stephen just said a wardrobe is a 옷장. Well, a 붙박이장 is an extended wardrobe that goes from one wall to the other.
And
right?
is attached, right?
Yes.
So usually it stays in the building. Yeah, 붙다 is to be attached or to attach, right? So it stays in the building. Usually they're built in, they're constructed while the building is being built. So that is a 붙박이장. It's more like a closet where I come from. Anyway.
And watch the pronunciation. It's really hard to say. Lots of people don't even know how to spell it correctly. Okay, 옷장 is with like a D sound. This is also the same. 붙박이장 is also like a D sound underneath the 붙. Okay, so 붙박이장.
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 Yeah, and I never move into a new house if they don't have one of these 붙박이장s, okay? Lisa says, 그래서 가져갈 필요가 없군요. That's why you don't have to take it with you, because you've got one there.
The key here is 필요가 있다, 필요가 있다, 필요가 없다. Please notice that you can have the necessity or not have the necessity. What? It's necessary or it's unnecessary. Now, 갈 필요가 없다. I don't have to go, right?
Yeah, right.
올 필요가 있다. Oh, you must come, right? You gotta go, gotta come. You're understanding this 일, when you attach that onto the original verb, you're saying, I've gotta do something in the future, right? Here we have, 가지고 갈 필요가 없다. I don't have to, oh, it's not 가지고 간다.
It's
가져갈, same thing. Yeah. 가져갈 필요가 없다. I don't have to bring it along, right? I don't have to bring one.
Let's try saying this, okay? 가져갈 필요가 없겠군요.
가져갈 필요가 없겠군요.
가져갈 필요가 없겠군요.
Stephen responds by saying, 옷장이 없어서 집에 엄청 넓어 보여요. The house looks very big, very spacious, because there isn't one, right? Yeah. Which is true, because if you take a wardrobe, it charges up so much space in your house. Right. If the 붙박이장 is already in there, obviously you don't have to take up so much space.
Yeah, when you move into a new place, you bring along this 옷장, and the place looked really big, and all of a sudden,
you stick one third of the space.
Yeah, you throw this big old 옷장, this big old wardrobe in there, and it gets much smaller. And then another word, 엄청. Now, this is something that I really like, because, like I said, I keep talking about, in Korean, there's so many words to place emphasis on stuff, right? Yeah, well, 엄청, 너무, 정말, 너무, is actually T-O-O, but they use it just for emphasis, like very or really. 진짜, 정말, well, all these kinds of words. Here's a new one for you. 엄청 넓어 보여요. It looks very wide, or otherwise big.
Right. And Stephen loves the color pink. 핑크색을 엄청 좋아해요. And so I've got a present for you, a matching drink.
That's nice. They heard me complaining to the coordinators as we were walking in. 핑크색 일부러 주는 거죠? You're just trying
deliberately.
To get, you're deliberately giving me this pink, these pink colors. Every episode I just get pink, more and more pink.
We just love you in pink, that's
okay,
why.
Apparently.
솔직히, actually, 핑크를 엄청 싫어해요. He doesn't like wearing pink. Let's go and take a look at today's Korean Insight. Korean Insight. What have you got there, Stephen? Grass?
No. These are sprouts, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
You gotta spread them out right. I'm gonna do me a little sprouts bibimbap. You got your bean sprouts and other kinds of sprouts. And this is, I'm giving you a little trend advice here, ladies and gentlemen. We always like to keep you guys up to date on the trendiest stuff. And, you know, the health is very important to Koreans nowadays. So they eat a lot of the bibimbap with the sprouts. It's
right.
called sesak. Bibimbap, right? Sesak. You gotta be careful on that pronunciation there. Se is new, right? They're sprouts, they're little babies. And then you got sak. Okay, it's that little sprout is what it's called. Sesak. Be careful that pronunciation.
And they say it's good for you. Bomnamu is also generally what it's called, is spring greens, right? And this is all really good for you because it speeds up your metabolism and obviously very healthy for you. But 근데 rabbit food? 간에 기별도 안 갈 것 같은데.
Oh,
we learned that yesterday, right?
Yeah,
for me, rabbit
good.
Food doesn't really fill me up, so I can't feel the difference. Anyways, eat that a little later.
Yes.
I'll
keep
you
yeah.
to kale.
Keep you
to kale.
I don't think I'm getting that back. Anyway, 옷장 we had was the wardrobe, right? And then we had 붙박. Be careful that pronunciation. 붙박. 박이장. 붙박이장. All together. And that was the built-in closets, right? Or the really huge attached closets. And then we had 갈 필요가 없다. I don't need to go. I don't need to bring it, however, is 가져갈 필요가 없다. Okay, and don't, no, stop that.
You need all right, let's get, take a look at our flash animation today.
Woo!
옷장을 그냥 버린다고요?
새 집에 붙박이장이 있거든요.
그래서 가져갈 필요가 없겠군요.
옷장이 없어서 집이 엄청 넓어 보여요. 히.
Alright, let's go and check out Marina's new house. 새 집을 볼 필요가 있거든요. We need to go and take a look at it. Here we go. It's a master layout, but we'll just cover just a few of the things. One of the things I wanted to cover is 안방. This is a word for main bedroom or master bedroom. 안방. What's something you'd like to put?
가구 is furniture. So what they do is usually 안방 is where they watch TV. So there'll be a lot of TV and stuff right here.
네.
But the most important thing is this. 붙박이장,
which
right?
isn't spelled right, so don't get it.
Yeah, our spelling's correct. They spelled it wrong,
right.
A little incorrectly. But notice it covers an entire wall of this small bedroom, which is more like a closet, it looks like.
It's a closet room, almost, like, right? Mm. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you back here next time. Bye-bye, everyone.
Bye-bye, everybody.